Can I read the next one?
All right.
Yeah.
Banging my roommate.
I'm reading
The Fallout. As read
by the lovely Nia. Hey, Billy Bitch Tits.
Make sure you don't block the microphone down the bottom.
Okay. I'm 22 years old in my last semester of university, and I live with one girl who happens to be hot. I found myself in this situation by only needing a four-month term sublease to finish my final semester. A friend of mine who was moving out of state to complete her nursing placement offered to sublet her room to me at a very reasonable price for the quality of apartment. I accepted without knowing or meeting my soon-to-be roommate. The hot roommate was briefed on me and was okay with living with a guy. Fast forward 2 weeks into living together, we're banging on the couch. Wow, that escalated quickly. Oh, there's somebody at the door.
All right.
I'll keep reading.
Okay.
We're banging on the couch. From this moment to about mid-October, I was untouchable. Insert picture of Muhammad Ali after a knockout. It was around that mid-October point where she decided to stop hooking up with me because she started talking to another guy from her hometown, 7 hours away. Where I have a problem is not with heartbreak or heart feelings. Oh, come on now. It's more with the level of resentment on her side. She's gotten really cold, standoffish, and passive-aggressive with me. It's to a point where she goes to her room when I get home. We don't really talk anymore. What have I done and how do I fix it? I'm not sure I see a future with her, but she's cool and I'd rather not have her hate me. She's a pretty laid-back person, and her mom constantly bugs her about getting a real job. She's a waitress. At the beginning of November, that is a real job. At the beginning of November, I got a job at a consulting firm, which I worked really hard to get. She didn't care in the slightest. While we were hooking up, she also told me constantly about the other guy she was talking to. Oh, baby. We agreed to be open, but I found it a bit much. Looking for a game plan here. Longtime fan of the show. Thanks and go fuck yourself.
So what happened? They start banging. And
ooh, child.
Somebody caught feelings. What happened?
He caught feelings. Even though he said, where I have a problem is not with heartbreak or hurt feelings. Yeah, she basically banged him because she was talking, because she was trying to get over some guy. While we were hooking up, she also constantly told me about the other guy she was talking to. Right. So this was a between guys bang. You know, it's kind of like a buffer, like because you're in between
a rebound,
or you're kind of wishing to be with somebody else. So you end up banging somebody who's really into you and is giving you a lot of compliments, and you know the dick is right next door because you're roommates, so that's super easy. You ain't gotta like get up and get all dressed up. It's like, you know, you'll just take it because you think I'm the best. And you know, you got used, you got played.
How did he get used? He got to bang a hot chick,
but he doesn't. But you didn't read, did you not hear the rest of it?
Like, no, I answered the door. You don't remember?
Oh, right. no, he's upset because she just dropped him like a hot potato, and she's being really cold to him and is not really talking to him.
Dude, that's the shit.
She used
that's
you.
The fucking shit.
It's over. It's
that's
done.
Fucking great. And this is the thing, dude. Just who gives a fuck?
I know.
You got to bang this hot chick, and then she acted the way a guy usually acts,
mm-hmm.
which is the best. Mm-hmm. We just walk away from it. Women are all like, can I have one of your t-shirts, right? She just walked away. Get on with your fucking life.
Exactly. It's done.
Yeah. Get on with your fucking life. Who
also,
gives a fuck?
You're 22 years old, so perhaps you haven't heard the saying, don't shit where you eat. Don't ever start fucking your roommate. Because when it goes bad or when it's over, very rarely can you just exist and it's not awkward.
Exactly. That's why it's fucking awesome, because now she's just totally blowing him off. They live together and then it's like perfect. So I would just sit down and just say, hey, listen, I realize we're not hooking up anymore, which is totally cool. But like, you barely even talk to me. Like, I don't have any fucking hard feelings over it. So like,
yeah,
you know, you want some Fruit Loops?
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, maybe kinda,
just try. Yeah, try to
like kind of call her out on being immature about the situation. It's like, you don't got to treat me like shit now just because we're not fucking. Because that's listen, I was sort of teasing you before, but it's not cool that she's just rude to you now that she's had your way with you and she's done with your dick and she's so free.
Dude, she's like the greatest roommate ever. All she wanted to do was fuck you for a while and then she left. What is the problem? She's on my Mount Rushmore of fucking roommates.
I mean, the fact that you got to bang her is pretty, because you could have easily gotten friend zoned. She's literally, she's sitting here constantly talking about other guys that she's seeing. You could have gotten friend zoned. So, you know, at least you got laid.
Yeah. Jesus Christ.
Silver lining.
The glass is not half full. The glass is full. Mm-hmm. And your balls are empty there. Oh, Jesus. All right.